Housing Act, the respecting the wishes of the residents. Each resident may be in a very different circumstance. There may be some that are in palliative care stages where they've got underlying, you know, cancer and their life is life limited. And it's a question of what does that individual person want? And that's why, you know, at the heart of the decision making, I really can't be stronger than saying it has to be about the care for the care for the residents and their wishes. I'm very happy to dispute, but just to let you know that all of the issues such as cohorting, removal from the facility, removing clean people. But in terms of talking to the infectious disease specialist at the time, one of his comments was if the facility had been decanted day one, then you would have misallocated a large number of people because of the incubation period and actually put people together that actually had the infection. And so there are challenges with whatever response we have. We have to balance risks and benefits, and we have to place the interest of residents at the heart of our decision making. And the doctors and the epidemiologist and the Anglicare and the Commonwealth have regular daily meetings, and all plans are on the table. To everyone, depending on whether they've been designated as a contact, there would have to be those arrangements. So if they wanted to go home to their family and they were a contact of the case, we would have to make sure everyone was fully understanding of what isolation meant, and that those, you know, we had monitoring in place for 14 days. So it goes, it applies to everyone, has to be assessed on a case-by-case basis. And we need to make sure everyone is fully aware of the care requirements for whatever option is taken.
Are there cases where healthy residents from March have been assisted in quarantining a hospital?
I'm not aware of those circumstances, but I'd be happy to follow that up.